I have quite a few videos on my YouTube channel on how to clean EGR valves, from how to get to it and then how to clean it. So this time, this is a video of how not to clean your EGR valve. So you have your EGR valve out and you'd like to clean it. So far, so good. This is from my 1.6 HDI Peugeot Partner 2007. Now you're thinking, what to use to clean it? These EGR cleaners, carburetor cleaners or brake and clutch cleaners are too expensive, so I need to go to the shop to buy some. It's 10 miles out and it will cost money. What do I have that I can clean it? You rummage through your cupboard. You're thinking out loud, oh, I know what to use. Oven cleaner. At the end of the day, these are carbon deposits here on the EGR valve, and in my oven, they are also baked carbon deposits. The oven cleaner cleans my oven pretty well, so it should work with the EGR valve. I already have it, so why not use it? But, oh, Mr. Muscle Drain Gel. Maybe I could use this as well. This drain cleaner will unblock my sink, so maybe it will unblock my EGI as well. I could try that one as well. I do get this sort of thinking in a lot of my comments about cleaning EGI valves. For example, oven cleaner, use oven cleaner, Mr. Muscle, which is an oven cleaner. In my last video about cleaning EGI valves, I put a pinned comment on not to use any sort of oven cleaners. People still comment on using oven cleaners. So if you do a quick YouTube search, EGR, oven cleaner, there is plenty of videos of showing how to do it, how to use oven cleaner and clean your EGR valve. So what is actually this EGR valve made of? Well, it's made of aluminium. It's just because it's excellent heat conductor. It just, when the engine gases go through here, it doesn't get too hot. So let's do an experiment then. I have some aluminium foil here, and I have my oven cleaner and the drain cleaner, the magic component. And let's see what happens if I put this with this aluminium foil. Let's do an experiment that will rival Cambridge and Harvard experiments. Cut a piece. Two equal pieces. Approximate. Two cups. Put one in there. Oh, let's not crimp it, it will be different. Put them in the glass. Oven cleaner. Oven's mate. Actually cleans my oven really well, this thing. Dump it in here. Oops, slightly above. There we go, one inside. Let's be quick, otherwise the experiment won't be too well. Mr. Muscle, drain cleaner and the budget component. It's also like a gel. Oops, too much. Nothing's happening. Let's mix them a bit. I can't mix this. It's way too jealous. Let's leave them there and I'll speed the camera a bit. So clearly something is happening in both, a huge bubble here, and this has moved a bit, so some reaction is going on. Well, let's leave this for, let's say, a half hour and see what's happening afterwards. So about an hour later, let's take this piece out. It's quite a... So that's the piece that is left. It's actually, I can tear it apart and it's extremely... Almost nothing left. What else is there? I mean, there is nothing else. This really disappeared. This is the Mr. Muscle, the drain cleaner. Sticking to my finger. Let's see the oven cleaner. Take this piece out. It's a bit difficult. Also almost nothing left. And I can disintegrate it in my fingers. It really disappears in my fingers. So that's the piece that is left. That's the piece that is out. Well, there is nothing else. I'm trying to rummage through, but there is nothing else. It's almost, if I had left it a bit more, it probably would have dissolved the whole thing. I'm not a chemist, but this is the chemical reaction that is happening. Basically, the aluminium turns into salt with some hydrogen released. And from video, you can, at the beginning of the video where I sped it up a bit, you can see how the hydrogen bubbles were coming out. I know what you'll say out there, but you kept it for an hour. I will do it for 10 minutes and then we'll be good. Now, you have used the oven cleaner to clean your EGR valve. It will be really shiny. I do not disagree at all. What you imagine is this. These EGR valves and the walls are really clean. I've cleaned it extremely well with this oven cleaner and they're really clean and smooth. Let's say this sheet of metal is the surface of the clean EGR valve. I have a bit of sand in my hand to simulate the carbon particles from the engine that will go through the EGR valve. You're thinking, this is really clean. So the carbon particles will just bounce off the walls and the EGR valve will stay clean for longer. Something like this. Nothing sticks to the surfaces of the EGR valve. But what is happening is this. Instead of having smooth EGR valve surfaces, you have this perforated barbecue grill. The potassium and sodium hydroxide have eaten the surface of the EGR valve. There are these small holes that you cannot see with naked eye, but they're still there. You still get the carbon from the engine that goes through the EGR, but this time, let's throw it again. And it sticks quite a bit here and there. So these bits will act as seeds for more and more carbon particles to stick to the surface of the EGR. In other words, your EGR valve will much more quickly become clogged. Well, I'm not too sure, I can probably throw it a few more times. Ah, there we go. Have a look at the pictures, a video of mine. The rougher the surface is, the more carbon particles will attach to it. Well, like this barbecue grill, see that bit here? It's attaching more and more, and you have more and more carbon particles attaching to it. So, do not use any sort of oven cleaner. Most of these will comprise sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide, or a combination of both. So this one for the oven cleaner is potassium hydroxide. On the Mr. Muscle is sodium hydroxide. The oven cleaner of Mr. Muscle, this is drain cleaner, but the oven cleaner of Mr. Muscle also contain sodium hydroxide. Both will eat the aluminium of EGR valve. Yes, you're thinking, I'll be quick. True, if you're really quick, it will do less damage, of course. But it will not clean the carbon deposits that well. So you have to wait a bit longer. And the longer you wait, the more aluminium is turned into salt, rough surfaces, and even more carbon deposits on your EGR valve. Of course, most people that would clean the EGR valve will then sell the vehicle on. Well, someone else's problem, of course. Not all, of course, and I'm talking to the sensible people out there. Please do not use any sort of oven cleaner to clean your EGR valve. If you value your car and your EGR valve, use dishwashing liquid. Something like this. Nearly everyone will have dishwashing liquid and it is a detergent. Use a toothbrush. Most people will have a toothbrush. Change your toothbrush and use that. Most people do not change a toothbrush often enough. So good opportunity to change your toothbrush and use that. Keep the toothbrush for the next EGR cleaning session. Let's say in a year or two. So that's it. Please do not use oven cleaner to clean your EGR valve. Thank you for watching. Let me know for any comments in the comment section. Thank you. This video has a bit of a comedy element to it, and I did that on purpose, so to make people maybe watch it a bit more and listen to it. Seriously though, do not use any sort of oven cleaner to clean your EGR valve. I realized after making the video that someone would point out in the comments the drain gel work faster than the oven cleaner, so you could use oven cleaner to clean your EGR valve. The oven's mate oven cleaner is a rather thick gel, so the reaction is a bit slower as compared to the drain cleaner. It's just a matter of concentration and thickness. Some oven cleaners will have a higher concentration of potassium hydroxide. Some others will have a higher concentration of sodium hydroxide, but all will dissolve aluminium. Of course, EGR valve might not be made of aluminium, so then go ahead, but it will have bits and pieces that will react to the potassium hydroxide in these oven cleaners. It might be slightly safer if it's made of cast iron or something else, but most will be made of aluminium. So thank you very much indeed again for watching. Hopefully some would find that information useful and will not use oven cleaner to clean the EGR valves. Thank you very much indeed again.